It is indeed an honor and a privilege this morning to just be able to worship and fellowship with you this morning. Almighty God, we thank you for your word this morning. Mighty God, we thank you, Lord God, for your divine presence. Mighty God, we thank you, Lord God, for clarity. We thank you for precision. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord God, that you have chosen me this morning to be your mouthpiece for your people. And so, Almighty God, continue to have your divine way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This morning, my topic is God's timing is everything. No matter what we do, no matter where we go, no matter what is going on in our life, God's timing is everything. And it is very important that we pay attention to God's timing. When we look in the natural, we see so many people, they're hustling, they're bustling from the train station or the bus stop. And if we take some time, we see that it is an interesting place because there's so many activities. You will see some people, they just saunter in. Some are walking sluggishly. They're still sleepy. They're really not in a hurry. And they're those people who try to pick a certain bus or a certain train to board because they believe they have all the time in the world. There's some people who believe that it is not time to give their hearts to the Lord because they think that they are young and they have all the time in the world. Some people, they would do anything at all, even to pay extra money to go somewhere. Some people, they're rushing on the highways and they meet in an accident because they're trying to meet their appointments. It all has to do with timing. And it is really a bad thing when you miss an appointed time. And so it is in the spiritual. When you miss your appointed time with God, it is a bad thing. It sets a negative course for your life. Time is an important part of our lives. And so many times we ask all these popular questions like, for example, how old are you? What is your experience? How long is that? Or how short it is? How long is the service? How long do I have to stay in church? And all these questions. But these are not of interest to God. Rather, the question that God is interested in is, what have you done with your time on earth? Did you feed the hungry? Did you clothe the naked? To God, every purpose of his has a time. The God we serve is very particular about time. In fact, from our birth until the moment we take our last earthly breath, our sovereign God is accomplishing his divine purposes in our lifetimes. He is in control of everything and everyone. No matter how much we think that we are in control, God is in control, and he is in control from everlasting to everlasting. One would think that as believers, when we understand the sovereignty of our Creator, that patience and waiting would come a little bit easier. Unfortunately, however, that's not always the case. Because of human nature, it can make waiting for God's perfect timing a difficult thing to do for some. In fact, in the hustle and bustle of this extremely busy life, some often find it difficult to wait for anything or anyone. They want what they want now because they live in a microwave society where you can actually just put the thing in the microwave and in 2 minutes or a minute, it's done. And now, more than anything else, with our modern technology, it is often easy to get what we want now. So as a result, this has spilled over into many believers. And not only are they losing their patience, but also finding it increasingly difficult to discern God's timing. Patience is a part of the fruit of the Spirit. And you can find that in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. The Bible tells us in Psalm 37, verse 7, be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Our patience often reveals the degree of trust we have in God's timing. We must remember that God operates according to his perfect and ordained eternal schedule, not ours. It should be a great comfort to us knowing that when we wait on the Lord, we receive divine energy and we receive divine strength. And the scripture for Isaiah 40 verse 31 tells us, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And the psalmist emphasizes this when he said, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Psalm 27, verse 14. A great key to understanding God's timing is trust, as I mentioned before. Our ability to wait on the Lord is largely related to how much we trust him. When we trust in God with all of our hearts, not relying on our own understanding, he will indeed give us direction. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6. Psalm 32, verse 10 reiterates that by saying, the Lord's unfailing love surrounds the man who trusts him. To fully trust God, however, we need to know God. And the best way to know him is through his word. God's divine energy is released into our lives through his inspired words. If we study and meditate on his word daily, his timing will become clear to us. Do not question God's timing, because when we question God's timing, it is often because you're looking for guidance or deliverance from a difficult situation. But my family, you can rest assured, however, that our Heavenly Father knows exactly where you are in your lives every moment. He either puts you there, yes, he will put you in some situation there, or he is allowing you to be there for all his own perfect purpose. In fact, God often uses trials to strengthen our patience, allowing our Christian faith to mature and become complete. James chapter 1, verse 3 to 4. And we know that all things, including these difficult trials, work out for the good of those who love God. Romans 8, verse 28. God does indeed hear the cries of his children and will answer those cries according to his perfect timing. Psalm 34, verse 19 says, a righteous man may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all. And we know that the plans God has for his children are good plans to help us and not to hurt us. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. God's timing, family, is always perfect. It is everything. God's never early, God's never late, but he's always on time. Our timing isn't God's timing. Where I am today, I never thought that I would be, but it was in God's timing. Sometimes God's timing feels like a long, desperate delay, but God's timing is perfect, and it does two things. Number one, it grows our faith as we are forced to wait and trust in God, and it makes certain that He, God, and He alone gets the glory and the praise for pulling us through. Not our friends, not our brother, not our sister, even though God may use them, but God gets the glory because we understand that He is the one that pulled us through. At the right time, God will provide for your need. At the right time, God will deliver you. At the right time, God will heal you. At the right time, God will rescue you. At the right time, His time, that's the right time. And for those who need healing, if you're in the bed laying down, use the time to reflect on your life. Use the time to strengthen your spirit. Use the time to strengthen yourself in the Lord. God has eternal perspective. God is a great I am who knows the past, the present, and the future. And what do we know if we compare to God? Nothing really when we compare to Him. So no matter how terrible or how impossible the situation appears, and I say appears, how awful you may feel, or how there appears to be no answer, no help, no hope, God will see you through because He is a perfect timekeeper. Everything is in the plan of God. And everything that is in the plan of God has been timed. Your miracle has its own appointed time. When Joseph was in prison, he interpreted the dreams of the chief butler and baker. According to his interpretation, the butler's dream meant that he would be restored to his job, while the one of the bakers meant that he would be killed. The butler was happy and promised to tell the king, but Joseph, when he is restored, but the Bible says that when the chief butler got to the king's palace, he forgot all about Joseph. Why did he forget? I believe God caused him to forget because that was not Joseph's time. That was not God's appointed time for Joseph. And 2 years after the man had forgotten, God himself brought him out. God has a timetable. He has a timeline for your life and for my life. The Lord is saying to you this morning, He said to us this morning, family, our time has come. It is time to reap the harvest. The children of Israel were in bondage for many years, but when it was God's time to bring them out, it took Him how many days? No days, only one night. Family, failure to move, because sometimes people just sit and do nothing. And failure to move when God is moving is very disastrous. You will find yourself living in a land of missed opportunity. How miserable can that be? The same is true for doing things at the wrong time will lead to disaster. To move outside of God's timing will end with defeat. When we try to walk ahead of God, the passion that drives that thing eventually runs out of steam. We end up running out of steam and looking towards the next thing. But the moment We press into God and seek his guidance and his direction. We begin to see the pathways unfold. We start to see a clearer picture of what we have said yes to in the first place. When we move in God's time, mighty God, all the things that he promises us comes to fruition. Now, this is the other side of it. If God moves and leaves you behind, you will be in grave danger. You will be miserable because you have missed his time. As a reminder, it is very dangerous to also take a shortcut when you're dealing with God. We saw what happened to Abraham and Sarah. The shortcut brought about Ishmael. God has his own plan for every life. That is why you must not use other people's lives as a yardstick to measure yours. Do not compare yourself with anybody else. God's plan for us may look alike, but they are different. Your personal plan for your life may lead you, your personal plan, not God's plan now, may lead you to failure and destruction if it is not in line with God's plan for you. There's some people, they abort the plan before it is completed. And that again makes people start searching and trying to start over, but they missed it. Does waiting on God mean do nothing? Absolutely not. Time may seem to be moving on around us, but there are some things that you can do while waiting on God. Focus on quiet time with God. Study your Bible and meditate on the Word of God. It makes it easier when you spend time getting to know God more. Learn more about your purpose. This is an excellent time to get to work on removing distractions. Cut down on the busyness in your life. See this time as a pause. Like, you know, when you're writing and you do a semicolon and not a full stop. After all, you are in God's waiting room. Spend time serving others. Set goals for the steps you already know. But remember, God created time and he is its master. His timing is perfect. He is never late. He is always at work for you and has been for eternity. Trust in him will bring you peace. Believing in his timeline will give you rest. Ecclesiastes 3 verse 11 says, he has made everything beautiful in its time. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Almighty God, I thank you for your word this morning. God, I thank you for reminding us, mighty God, that your timing is everything. And Almighty God, I pray in the name of Jesus that as we go forth, Lord God, we will continue to pray for that patience, mighty God, so that we can stay in your waiting room until it is time for you to bring us forth. God, continue to have your divine way. Cover us, mighty God, underneath your blood. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.